Praise the Lord, precious saints, and welcome to another daily prophetic utterance to start your day. God is saying to you today, situations sent from hell to try and take you out have been divinely interrupted and nullified. You made it this far, and my hand is upon you. Things that have tormented you will become your testimony in the future. Remain at peace. Wait upon me, especially upon my timing. Remember, I go before you to fight for you, against your enemies to save you. I am with you, and I am always watching over you to sustain you, that no harm will be done to you. I am your protection. I am your justice. I am your savior, and will break in pieces the enemy that oppresses you. I am your strong tower and your place of refuge. I am your defender. So do not think that you need to ever face the hordes of hell by yourself. I have not sent you to the battlefield to fight, but to be my vessel to stand upon the land in boldness and in my strength. For as you walk in obedience to my direction and my command, the armies of darkness will fail and fall by your side. Every arrow and every weapon against you will be destroyed. Every enemy that comes against you will run away in fear. Everything that tries to stand against you will fail. Have I not made a hedge around you, around your household, and around all that you have on every side? Yes, as you submit to me and obey my word, I will bless the work of your hands. So all your possessions shall be a blessing in the land of the living. I encamp my angels 24 hours a day around those that fear me, and I will always deliver you in times of trouble. Yes, they are my ministering spirits, sent forth to minister to you who inherit salvation. For I will be a supernatural wall of fire all around those that trust in me, to insulate you from any assaults of the devil. And I will be the glory within your midst, covering your rear guard. You do not have to be afraid, my children, for I am your shield and protector, your exceedingly great reward. I have given you the keys of the kingdom. Whatever you bind on this earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatever is loosened on earth shall be loosened in heaven. Learn to take refuge in my presence, for that is the secret place, that you are safe. That's right. I will rescue you from hidden traps of the enemy. I will shield you from deadly hazards. With my huge outstretched arms, I will protect you, for under them you're perfectly safe. My arms fend off all harm near you. Do not fear anything, not wild wolves in the night, not flying arrows in the day, not disease that prowls through the darkness, not disaster that erupts at high noon. Even though others succumb all around you and drop off like flies on your right and left, no harm will gaze you, for you'll stand untouched and watch it all from a distance. Yes, because I am your refuge. Evil can't get close to you. Harm can't get through your door, for I have ordered my angels to guard you wherever you go. Even if you stumble, I have commanded them to catch you. Yes, their orders and job description is to keep you from falling. You'll walk unharmed among lions and snakes, and kick young lions and serpents from the path before you. That is right. You will kick them from the path before you. For my plans cannot be thwarted or defeated. As you place your trust in me, I will protect you. I will sustain you. I will strengthen you, and I will give you every weapon of heaven to fight the battle that I have called you to do. So do not fear, but stand in my power and watch the mountains move at your command and the rivers change course at your word. Face every single ploy of the enemy, knowing that I will not allow anything to touch or harm you. Remember, your mind is Satan's battlefield if you allow it to be flooded with thoughts of worry, fear, perversion, rejection, hatred. So take all thoughts captive, which then pulls down the strongholds of wrong thinking to have victory. Do not be afraid. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord within your life, for you shall see your enemies again no more, and I will fight for you, and you shall hold your peace. Always remember, I hear all your cries and prayers. My thoughts about you outnumber more than the sands of the sea. I love you with an everlasting love, and Satan, who is the father of all lies, but remember this, I have never lied nor broken a promise. I am the God of second chances, and nothing is too hard nor impossible for me. With man it is impossible, but with me all things are possible. My word does not return void. Has it not been written that I will even magnify my word above all names? My word is settled in heaven forever. You need to trust me and my word no matter what trials or tribulations that you are facing, whatever mountain, valley, desert, storm, or Goliath that is in your life, learn to trust me and be at peace this day as I am with you. Shalom. Hallelujah. 2 Thessalonians 3 verse 3 says, but the Lord is faithful, who will establish you and guard you from the evil one. God is faithful, and he will never leave you nor forsake you. And he has promised to protect you from the evil one. In a world that is full of broken promises, this is something that we can know and rely on. We don't have to defend ourselves from the onslaught of an orphan world system because he has promised to defend and protect us. After all, he is our father and he is a good father. Hallelujah. The true essence of God's protection is the eternal indwelling of the Holy Spirit, according to Ephesians 2, verse 21 to 22. The believer is sealed for the day of final glorification, according to Ephesians 1, 13 to 14. A shield can only protect if it is picked up and used. We cannot sit back and say, God will protect me, if we have not done the things we ought to be doing. It is only through prayer and studying of God's word that we are assured of God's protection in our lives. Naaman chapter 1 verse 7 says, God is good, a stronghold in the day of trouble, and he knows those who trust him. He tells us we have worth our value in his eyes. He is our helper who has compassion, mercy, and grace for each of us. God's forgiveness is bigger than our sins. If we confess our sins, then God is faithful to forgive and just to forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Hallelujah. Deuteronomy 24 says, and for the Lord your God is, and he goes with you to fight for you against your enemies to save you. Psalm 34 verse 6, the poor man cries out, and the Lord heard him and saved him out of all of his troubles. Hallelujah. And according to Psalm 34 verse 17 onwards, the righteous cry out, and the Lord hears and delivers them out of all of their troubles. The Lord is near to those who are brokenhearted and saves such that have a contrite spirit. Hallelujah. According to Psalm 72 verse 4, he will bring justice to the poor of the people, and he will save the children of the needy, and will break in pieces the oppressor. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for your amazing protection within our lives. Thank you for rescuing us from all of life's harms. Thank you for your shelter and guidance. Thank you for being our strong tower and for the safe place to hide under your wings. Thank you, Lord, for covering us with your mighty wings. We love you, Lord. Guide us in your path of righteousness and let us rest our care forever that we may know you. Lord, we pray in the name of Jesus, the name above every name and all things. We bind up every unclean spirit and assignment coming against us from anywhere, from our children, from our families, Lord, from by or through anyone or anything, or name of or unnamed, known or unknown. Lord, going back seven generations, in the name of Jesus, we bind up the principalities, powers, rulers of the darkness of this world, spiritual wickedness and hosts in high places, and the prince of power of the air. In the name of Jesus, we bind up the strong man, the old man, every prince and strong man, and spirit of Antichrist, every evil spirit and plague, the spirit of confusion, illusion and delusion. In the name of Jesus, we bind up the spirit of infirmity, sickness, disease, pain, addiction, affliction, calamity, the devourer, the destroyer, the accuser, the deceiver, the corrupter, and every spirit of poverty. In the name of Jesus, we bind up the spirit of strife and division and backbiting and gossip and critical and judgmental spirits. Lord, we pray also and bind up the spirits of resistance and hindrance and every spirit of retribution, revenge or retaliation, and lying and seducting and deceiving spirit of deception right now. In the name of Jesus, we bind up every root of fear, doubt, unbelief, discouragement, and every deadly spirit of despair and depression, the spirit of pride, rebellion, disobedience, self-ego, independence, unforgiveness, bitterness, lust, perversion, and of the flesh right now. And we pray in the Lord Jesus Christ, we rebuke you, evil, unclean spirits. We loose in the name of Jesus Christ deliverance, freedom, and liberation, peace, joy, hope, gladness of heart, love and healing and wholesomeness, mercy and grace, blessings and favor, restoration of the years that the locusts have eaten, the resurrection power of Jesus Christ, a mighty harvest and a boldness to witness for Christ. Lord, we pray for healing, deliverance and freedom, and every evil spirit bound right now and cast out back to the pit of hell right now in the name of Jesus Christ. You will come under the obedience of Christ right now. We command you in the name of Jesus Christ. You will come out of them and go back to the pit of hell right now in the name of Jesus Christ. We declare through the anointing of the Holy Spirit, we bind every spiritual being that has been coming against them right now in the name of Jesus Christ. We declare and we thank you for the fire of the Holy Spirit that come down from heaven right now in the name of Jesus. Locate any spirit right now that needs to be located by fire right now. We command every spirit to leave each person in the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you for the fruits of the Holy Spirit that will fill them with love, with joy, with peace. Right now, fill their souls. We thank you, Lord, that you are our protector. We thank you, Lord, that you defeat and nullify and terminate every plan of the enemy that is opposing or coming against our lives. We give you all the praise. We thank you for your goodness. We thank you that you are the God that healeth thee. You are the God that delivereth thee. You are the God that protects us. We thank you for your protection, and we give you all the praise. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. This is Pastor Robert Clancy from Narrowpath Ministries in Perth, Western Australia. It is time to catch the fire of repentance revival as we prepare for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Shalom, shalom, shalom. And if you've liked this post and you haven't already, subscribe, hit that button right now, and also forward to a friend that they may be blessed today. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Shalom, shalom, shalom.